Hello students, we know many things about acids and bases by now, but do we know one thing? If all the acids are similar to each other, can we use all of them in our daily lives? And can we use all the bases in our daily lives? Just like lemon, tomatoes, tamarind, all of these have some acid present in them and all of them are edible. Can we use hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid in our cooking or to cook some food? Of course not. They will burn everything around them. So there are some acids which are edible and there are some acids which are very corrosive. So that is the reason to know the difference between them, we have to learn about the classification of acids and bases. So let's see how are acids classified. Okay. Now acids are classified first way on the basis of their source, from the source they come from. Alright, so acids can either come from plants, animals or humans, so they are called organic acids, and they can also come from minerals. Minerals are nothing but materials that we can find in the earth's crust, so they are called minerals. So if we can manufacture or get the acids from minerals, they are called mineral acids. Now, organic acids are usually hydrocarbons, remember? That means compounds which contain carbon and hydrogen in them along with some other elements too. But usually they are hydrocarbons. So these hydrocarbons which are found mainly from the materials found from plants, animals or humans, these acids will be termed as organic acids. And those found from minerals are termed as inorganic or mineral acids. So let's see some examples. Under organic acid, we have lactic acid, which is found in curd, and curd is formed from milk, and milk comes from an animal. Then we have citric acid. Citric acid is present in all the citrus fruits, like lemon, sweet lime, oranges, etc. Then we have oxalic acid, which is found in tomatoes. We also have tartaric acid, which is found in tamarind. Now these acids are quite edible because they are weak acids. Whenever they fall on our skin or we eat them, we do not feel that burning sensation because they are not very corrosive. That is because they are called weak acids. Okay, let's talk about mineral acids. Under mineral acids, we have hydrochloric acid. Usually these acids are used in laboratories. Okay, sulfuric acid. Then we have nitric acid. All these acids are mineral acids and they are very, very corrosive. They can burn anything around them. They can even burn the metals, which are very strong. So these acids are called strong acids because they are very corrosive. So remember, the organic acids are usually weak and we can even consume them. And mineral acids are very strong, very corrosive, which cannot be used for our domestic purposes. So usually they are used in industries and in laboratories. Okay, now organic acid also has one more acid, formic acid. In this category, we have formic acid. Formic acid is the acid which is present in the bee sting and the ant sting. Usually we say that the ants bite, but they don't. They instead throw some acid on us for their self-defense. And that acid is formic acid. It causes a lot of irritation and pain, right? But this irritation and pain is not that bad as it would have been caused by these acids, hydrochloric, sulfuric or nitric. They can burn our skin. So that is why formic acid is a mild acid, which is organic and it is a weak acid. So, and these acids are strong. Now, there is one more acid which is a mineral acid, but it is not strong. And that is the carbonic acid. Carbonic acid is present in the colas which we have, okay, the aerated drinks. Now these aerated drinks have carbon dioxide and water mixed, so due to which carbonic acid is formed. And this carbonic acid is quite edible, don't you think we consume it? Okay, so being a mineral acid, still it is not strong. So except carbonic acid. Alright, So I hope you are clear with why don't we use these hydrochloric, sulfuric or nitric acid in our food, because they are not at all edible. They are very strong, very corrosive. Alright, now the next thing that we need to know is, be it any acid. be it a strong acid, be it a weak acid, these acids can either be concentrated or they can be dilute. Okay, concentrated means, you have to remember one thing first, that acids are acids because they dissolve in water. Only in the presence of water they can show their acidic property. So if water is more as compared to acid, then that acid is dilute. And if acid is more as compared to water, then that acid is concentrated. More acid and more water if it is dilute. So remember, to make any acid dilute, we have to add water to it. Okay, do you know what is acetic acid? Acetic acid is nothing but the vinegar we use. Now in that vinegar, acetic acid is only 8% and the rest of the solution is water. So that is a dilute acetic acid solution where water is much more than the acid present. So I hope you are clear with all these ideas. Now let's go to see what is the classification of bases. Okay students, bases just like acids can be organic and inorganic depending upon the source they come from. But basically we do not classify bases on the basis of the source, but we classify them as strong and weak just like acids. Okay, so they can be strong or they can be weak. How do we know the difference between them? Strong bases are very corrosive and weak bases are very mild. They can also be consumed. So in strong bases, we have two examples. One is sodium hydroxide. And these bases which are strong are usually not used for domestic purposes. Instead, they are used in industries. We have potassium hydroxide. Okay, and in weak bases, we have the one with which toothpaste are made. That is ammonium hydroxide. Then we also have a base with which an antacid is made, magnesium hydroxide. What are antacids now? Okay, we suffer from acidity sometimes, and to reduce the acidity, we need to have a base, and that base is magnesium hydroxide, which can be consumed. So if this can be consumed, it has to be a mild base because we cannot consume strong bases because they are very corrosive. Alright, and the third example here is calcium hydroxide. In Hindi, it is known as chuna. Now, this calcium hydroxide is used for various purposes. Like for example, treating the soil. If the soil becomes very acidic, we can treat it with a base so that it becomes neutral for plant growth. Now, for that, we use calcium hydroxide base because it is a mild base and it will not affect the plants. So, these are the examples of strong and weak base. Again, we have to remember one thing here is, strong or weak bases can either be concentrated or dilute. So again, what would be a concentrated base? A base in which base is more and water is less. And what would be a dilute base? Water is more and less base. So that's a dilute base. So remember, be it a strong base or a weak base, it can either be concentrated or dilute. Alright, so we can have sodium hydroxide as concentrated, we can also have it as dilute. We can have ammonium hydroxide as concentrated or dilute. So this is the basic classification of acids and bases. Now let's move ahead and see if we can dilute an acid or a base, how do we do it? Okay students, let's talk about dilution. Now imagine if this is the solution of acid. Okay, and if you talk about a small volume here, you will find a lot of acid is there. Okay, in the second volume, a lot of acid is there. Third, same volume, same small volume, okay? These are same volume that I'm taking. Acid, acid, acid. And somewhere in between, we have water. Water, 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 water. This indicates that it is a concentrated right now, and less amount of water, more amount of acid is present per unit volume. Because in a small volume, you will see more amount of acid present. Now, what happens if we add more water? If we add more water to this, you will find that, okay, if I have added more water. Now, due to which what happens is, all the acid particles will spread out throughout. So, if acid particles spread out, and if you check this small volume now, you will find that in this small volume, little amount of acid is remaining. So, we can say that concentration of acid has decreased per unit volume, and this is what we call dilution. So dilution is nothing but decreasing the concentration of acid or a base. Even with the base, the similar thing happens, or a base by adding more amount of water. Okay, per unit volume, decreasing concentration of acid or base per unit volume by adding more amount of water. Now dilution, what happens with dilution is, due to dilution, acid effect becomes less. So if we talk about vinegar that we use, vinegar has more amount of water and less amount of acid. But still, if you just consume vinegar, you will find some, some characteristic odor of the vinegar or a little burning sensation. But if it was more in amount, the acid, it would have been a little more corrosive. So to reduce the corrosion of any acid, we can add water to it. Now, what is the procedure of dilution? Can we take acid and just add water? What would happen? The beaker or the test tube in which acid is taken, where we are adding water, it will just splash or blast out. Okay, remember that always we cannot have acid and we cannot add water to it. Instead, we should always add acid to the water while diluting. Now, suppose in this test tube, I have water. Okay, and I add acid drop by drop. And I have to continuously stir. Remember, whenever acid and water come together, a lot of heat is evolved, okay? A lot of heat in this reaction. So due to which, what happens is, suppose your heat would be evolved. Okay, a lot of heat would be evolved. Now, this heat would be absorbed by the cold surface of the water. And secondly, we are adding acid less drop by drop. So, the heat evolved will not be much. And secondly, it would be absorbed by the cold surface of the water. So, this would not cause a problem. But instead, if we have acid and we add water, then what would happen? Then obviously, a lot of heat is going to come out. And this heat will not be absorbed by anything. So due to which, this mixture can splash out and cause burns on your hand. Remember, because in laboratory, whenever dilution takes place, it is of corrosive acids. Corrosive acids can burn anything around them. So always remember, for dilution, always add acid to water and not water to acid, because the reaction is highly endothermic. Endothermic means a lot of heat is given out during this dilution. So I hope you are clear with what is dilution and what measures are to be taken while diluting the acid. And for the base also, we have to follow the same thing.